Many botnets use DNS for CNC. A key advantage is that DNS is used whenever a machine on the internet needs to talk to another machine because DNS stores the mapping between domain name and IP address. That is, DNS is always allowed in a network, and therefore using DNS for CNC won't stand out easily. In this example here, the botmaster releases malware, and in the malware, the domain name of the CNC server is hard-coded. Now the malware spreads, then the question is, how do the bots communicate back to the botmaster? In other words, how do they perform CNC with the CNC server? To perform CNC, each bot is instructed to communicate to the CNC server. As we said, the CNC server is identified by the domain name, so the first thing the bot will do is to ask the DNS server, hey, what's the IP address for hacker.com? And the DNS server will tell the bot, here's the IP address. And then the bots would actually communicate to the CNC server. And that's how botnet CNC works through DNS. The kind of DNS service providers preferred by the botmasters are the dynamic DNS providers because they allow the frequent changes of the mapping between domain name and IP address. That is, the botmaster can change to use another machine. Instead of 10.0.0.1, for example, he can change it to 10.0.6.2, for example, as the CNC server for the same botnet. And all he needs to do is log into the dynamic DNS provider and change the mapping so that now hackers.com points to the new IP address. If we can detect that hackers.com is used for botnet CNC, then we can detect that any machine that connects to it is a bot. But the question is, how do we know that hackers.com is used for botnet CNC? It turns out that the way that bots look up a domain would suggest that this domain is most likely used for botnet CNC. That is, the way that bots look up a domain would be different from a machine that looks up a web server because of legitimate user activities, such as when the user is looking up a news website. For example, if a domain, such as hackers.com, is being looked up by hundreds of thousands of machines all over the internet, and yet, this domain is unknown to Google search. This is an anomaly. Therefore, we can use anomaly detection at the dynamic DNS provider to examine queries to DNS domains in order to identify botnet CNC domains. Once we identify that hackers.com is used for botnet CNC, there are a number of responses available. One option is for the dynamic DNS provider to set a mapping of hackers.com to the IP address of a sinkhole. That is, instead of giving the IP address of the CNC machine to the bots, the dynamic DNS provider would give the IP address of the sinkhole to the bots. Therefore, instead of connecting to the actual CNC server, all the bots would be connecting to a sinkhole machine. As a result, the botmaster will not be able to command his bots because when he logs to the CNC server and looks through the logs, he will not be able to find the bots because all the bots are instead communicating with the sinkhole machine. With the sinkhole, in addition to disabling the botnet operations, security researchers can learn where the bots are. For example, by looking at each connection from the bot to the sinkhole, security researchers would know the IP address of each bot. Therefore, it would know where the bots are throughout the internet.